and it's my pleasure to introduce Gary Barwin. Gary Barwin is from everywhere and can do everything. He was born in Dublin to immigrants from South Africa, so he has a bit of Europe, a bit of Africa, and a bit of Canada in his soul. He's a multimedia artist, a composer, and a teacher, as well as a writer of poetry, children's books, and fiction. Yiddish for Five Pirates is his first novel, but something like his 20th published book. And it was shortlisted for the Governor General's Prize and the Dealer Awards before finally winning something with us here. Yiddish for Pirates is a rollicking, tongue-twisting tour de force, introducing us to the most memorable Yiddish-speaking parrot in modern literature. And it's a compelling, central character who maintains a level of innocence and menschlichkeit even in the midst of the Spanish Inquisition and a career in piracy. There is terrific virtuosity in Barwin's self-conscious punning and multilingual wordplay, and that's much of the initial pleasure of the novel. But underneath all the fun is the old and painful legacy of oppression that runs deep in our history and consciousness. For while Barwin's parrot kibitzes with style, the story he tells includes horrors that are no laughing matter. The imperative to crack wise in the face of devastation is one of the great legacies of Jewish literature, from Shlomo Aleichem to Ivy Singer, from Saul Bellow to Grace Paley and Mordechai Richler. Yiddish for Pirates takes its place alongside this estimable lineage with a raunchy squawk. It is my great pleasure to congratulate this year's winner of the Canadian Jewish Literary Award for Fiction, Gary Barwin.
Thank you all for being here. One of the inspirations for my novel was a historical figure, a pirate from a family of rabbis, who came out of retirement for one last exploit, to retrieve some treasure. What was the treasure? Some Jewish books. To me, this seemed like such a perfectly Jewish way to be a pirate. In my novel, I quote a Yiddish proverb, "The tongue is not in exile." No matter where Jews found themselves, when we were forced to leave our homes for immigration or expulsion or persecution, we had to leave often without any of our possessions. We could always bring our language, our stories, our teachings, our jokes and sayings. The tongue is not in exile. So wherever we went, we brought ourselves with us. I don't know if language is our shadow or if we are language's shadow, but to me, to be a Jew is to believe in language and to believe in books. So it's a really very special honor to receive this recognition for the Canadian Jewish Literary Awards. Thank you to the clearly very wise jury and everyone else involved in organizing. I really am very honored. And congratulations to my fellow award winners, especially my old friend Stuart Ross. It's a thrill to be here with him. We've been friends and writing colleagues for 35 years or something since we first met at York. And also to my family for making the book and everything else possible. My wife, my parents, my in-laws, and my kids. And you know that old joke which asks, so when is a Jewish fetus viable? When is a Jewish fetus viable? After it graduates from law or medical school. But now I'm hoping that winning this award has finally made me viable. So I'd like to speak a little bit from the very beginning of the book. A bar mitzvah boy goes to a retirement home to get the story of his family from his zaidi, but the zaidi's asleep. But he has a parrot, and so the parrot tells the story. Yeah. Hello! How are ya? You think those are the only words I know? Boy chick, you don't know from knowing. You ain't seen knowing. I may be mush and go crazy, but I know from words. You think I'm a fool schmaghetti? I'm all words. Hello? If you want the story of a life, don't wait for your alta caca old gramps over there to wake up. Maybe he'll never wake. But me, listen to my words. They tell some story, because I remember. Sometimes too much, but I remember. So new, bench your fat little whisker patch in a Cape Horn tuchus, down on that chair and listen to my beaking. Come all ye brave lads, and so forth. I'll tell you the whole Megillah story from fore to aft. What's it about? Pirates, parrots, Jews, jewels, the Inquisition, gefilte fish. Gold, a girl,
Boy chick, I was a pirate's parrot, and had I not nushed from the fountain of eternal youth hundreds of years ago, I would rest beside my sturdy captain and Davy Jones, himself at the bottom of the sea where the soulless creatures crawl. And then where would you be? Without a story. That life was a book made into a life, a wonder tale, the glinty waves, the deep jungle, a world I wouldn't have believed if I hadn't sailed right into it. And for a time, that world had but one shoulder, blue and fussy with epaulettes, hanging off the rigging of a stolen frock coat, a cutlass of a collarbone covered in flesh like mangy beef jerky. My captain's shoulder. These days, no one wants to hear, maybe not even you. They treat us like leftovers, wizened chicken gizzard pupilas in this birdhouse of leftover yids. But no, it's true. Most of us look like yesterday's chicken or its gizzards. Though look at these feathers, a young bird would be proud of such praise. The shalom home for the aged. Too often, stories in this library of lost people are told in the vermished, confused language of forgetting. But I speak many languages, and I'm fluent in both remembering and forgetting. No, it's easier to tell the stories you remember, or pretend to. And what you don't remember, the stories tell for you. Ah, I talk too much. I've got myself twisted to break with words turncoating again, thinking about my bastard mum, the captain himself. But what do you expect? 500 years old, I'm an Altakaka geezer of the highest degree, with a brain like a cabbage roll, a parrot brain like a chameleon on Jewish tartan. They wanted our souls for eternal barbecue, so we traveled with Columbus into that brave new world as the cross of vast and chilly Jordan, an undividing Red Sea. And what did the ancients find? A promising land, thousands of years of history, regret, happiness, the future. And what did we find? Ah, this is a pirate tale I'm telling you, so it has to be treasure. So new, you ask, what is this treasure and where is it buried? This I'll try to answer, as well as another, the big question of all stories. And then what happened? Yes, it brings muzzle for a pimply boy like you to hear about blood, kishkas, guts, dangerous books, and stirring. It puts some hair between your ears and above your skinny dick schmeckle. You like it. So new? In the beginning, what was that? A beginning. Thanks very much.